Now this section is a description of my own journey. I was born in East Africa and my family migrated back to India when I was 10 years old. And that's where I grew up. I had two major experiences at the ages of about 18 and about 21, which completely colored my future journey, and I'd like to tell you about them. When I was about 18, I was in my first year of college after finishing high school, and that's when I was sitting on a wall facing the sea. And as I remember it, I experienced a thought that seemed to come from the horizon and embedded itself into my mind, rather like a download. And the thought was quite simple. It said that the world you see around you is the way you see it. You can't see the way things are. Everything in your world is subjective. There is something that is behind everything, but you can't see it. And for some reason, the thought that came with it completely took me over. And the more I thought about it, the more it seemed that everything in life that I knew was completely subjective. And there was a deep yearning to find something that was objective, as it were. And in search of these things, I began to look around and see what I could find in my environment. And this led me to search in the subject of philosophy. And reading through books, I came across people that had had the exact same question as me over time. And I found this in the field of Western philosophy, in a particular branch called epistemology, or the theory of knowledge. And I spent time studying people like Immanuel Kant, Baruch de Spinoza, who had framed the question, but they had no answer to the question of ultimate truth or ultimate human knowledge. In the course of my studies, I came across this book called the Bhagavad Gita, which was the important scripture from India. And when I began to look through its pages, it seemed to say that all my thoughts were quite right. The world was not as it was just as it appeared to me, and that there was a reality behind all the appearances that presented themselves to me, but they couldn't be found with the ordinary mind. And the Bhagavad Gita described a kind of path that one could follow, and this would open one up to a different kind of mind, as it were. And for some reason that I cannot explain, the book completely spoke to me and took me over. And without wasting a single minute, I started to follow the directions to the very best of my ability, 24 hours a day. And this put me into a kind of an emotional state. And as I recall it, about 2 weeks after turning the first page of the Bhagavad Gita, I was walking along a road at about 8:30 in the morning. This was in February of 1975. And I had the most amazing experience, which I later discovered was analogous to what people had called an experience of cosmic consciousness. I found that my whole brain, or my whole world, seemed to melt into a field of dazzling light. And the experience lasted maybe only 4 seconds, but in this time it was like a curtain was drawn aside, and I had a glimpse into what was another world. It was a world that in which I saw that time and space in which I lived were part of a much larger structure. And this other structure was immortal, out of space, out of time, and it was incredibly alive. And with this experience, I experienced a profound healing, a feeling of a profound sense of love and a yearning to go there. And the experience shut itself off after about 4 or 5 seconds, as I recall it, but it left a taste for searching in these things. As I later discovered, my experience was analogous to that of many others who had experienced very similar things. And it led me to start the search for gurus, teachings, teachers, philosophies, things like this. And that journey started in 1975 and continued and continued and continued. I later discovered things that appealed to me and so forth. So in the course of time, I mean over the past something like 30 years, obviously you see a lot of things, you meet a lot of people, you read a lot of books and so forth, and you go through a lot of inner experiences that develop your knowledge of the field. Now in 2007, I had a whole host of new experiences, and these led me to want to share what I had found with a wider audience of people. And I had a series of very powerful dreams at the time, which led me to put down my thoughts in diagrams and words and things like this, and ultimately into the series of lectures that I have discussed and that you have seen. And when I had completed it, it actually felt that it was complete. It was almost like something that had been channeled from another place was coming through me and using my faculties to talk about this knowledge. And I hope that what I have given is of use to people and will be of help to people going forwards. Thank you.